Welcome back to another session in Dentistry and More. Topic for today is Mucocele or Ranula. So mucus is the exclusive secretory product of the accessory minor salivary glands and the most prominent product of the sublingual gland. So which is the most prominent product of sublingual gland. So the mechanism for mucus cavity development is either extravasation or retention. So these two mechanisms can result in mucus cavity development. So extravasation is nothing but the leakage of fluid from the decks or acini into the surrounding tissue. That is, extra means outside, the vasa means the vessel. Okay, so outside the vessel there will be leakage of fluid and it will be collected into the surrounding tissue. Whereas the retention, it is a narrowed ductal opening which cannot adequately accommodate the exit of saliva which is produced, which leads to the ductal dilation and surface swelling. So which is a less common phenomena, this is the most common phenomena. So this is happens when the ductal opening is narrow that cannot adequately accommodate the saliva. So what happens is it leads to ductal dilation and surface swelling. So Mucocele, which is exclusive of the irritation fibroma. So Mucocele is irritation fibroma, which are the most common type of benign soft tissue masses in the oral cavity. Benign soft tissue mass, which is irritation fibroma and as a benign soft tissue mass. So muco means mucus and the seal means a cavity. So when this Mucocele occurs in floor of the mouth, which is known as ranula. So the Mucocele in the floor of the mouth is known as ranula. So this Mucocele, which consists of a circumscribed cavity in the connective tissue and submucosa, which producing an obvious elevation in the mucosa. So that is how it has got an elevation, a dome-shaped elevation. So the majority of the Mucoceles results from an extravasation of fluid into the surrounding tissue after the traumatic break in the continuity of the decks, and it doesn't have a true epithelial lining. So there is no true epithelial lining for the mucosa. Epithelial lining, I mean lining for the Mucocele. So what is ranula? Okay, ranula, I told you, the Mucocele which is seen in the floor of the mouth. So this term used for the Mucoceles occur in the floor of the mouth. Why it has got that peculiar name? Because the word rana, because it resembles the swelling. This swelling resembles the translucent underbelly of the frog. As you can see the picture here, underbelly of frog. That is why it has got that peculiar name, because this swelling resembles the translucent underbelly of the frog. And it has got classification such as congenital or acquired, and it is also be found in newborn infants. Etiology, as I told, there will be an obstruction of one of the salivary glands, and it is mostly a retention cyst, and there will be spontaneous or results after a surgery of the floor of the mouth, especially then this submandibular duct area. So this extravasation cyst, which can be arising from the gland of Nunn or Blantin, or also can be, you know, the gland of Blantin and Nunn, and it can occasionally from submandibular gland, which is also in that region. So initially there is a blockage of duct which causes retention cyst, and with increased pressure there is rupture of SNA leading to extravasation cyst. So first is retention cyst that will be rupturing and it's becoming an extravasation cyst, and it is a smooth cystic swelling under the tongue, usually on one side, and it presents as a blue dome-shaped swelling in the floor of the mouth, which is overlying the blood vessels. So they tend to be larger than mucoceles and can fill the floor of the mouth completely, and it can also elevate the tongue. And if it is very larger, it can affect both breathing and swallowing. So it has got a different variety, that is plunging or cervical ranula. So it occurs when the spilled mucin dissects through the mylohyoid muscle and produces swelling in the neck. So extravasation of mucus occurs behind the confines of the floor of the mouth through the mylohyoid muscle into the upper neck or submental region. It is like soft, cross, flectuant, non-tender, dumbbell-shaped swelling in submandibular region, and it can be bidigitally palpable. And it is quite difficult to distinguish from cystic hygroma, but it can be easily picked up by MRI because hygroma has simple epithelial lining, ranula contained very loose connective tissues. So treatment of ranula is excision with strict removal of any projecting peripheral salivary glands, and always try to avoid injury to other glands during the primary wound closure. And we can also do simple aspiration or drainage, but it will result in high recurrence. So both simple and plunging ranula needs excision of the cyst wall and sublingual gland. There should be great care to preserve the lingual nerve. Sometimes this ranula presenting in neck may need cervical incision. So that is all about ranula. We are discussing about the mucocele and ranula. Mucocele is a dome-shaped fluid-filled cavity because of the rupture of the salivary glands, minor salivary gland. And ranula, which is happening in the floor of the mouth, and because of the peculiar shape, it looks like underbelly frog. It has got this name, ranula. And the types and how it forms, extravasation and retention process. Finally, the treatment part. So I'll come up with a new topic in dentistry and more. Thank you.